Hello, welcome back. My name is Dr. Chaitanya, and today we are going to learn about the practical number 3. These things you should be note down in your record book. So coming to the today's practical, that is the pneumonia. Before going to the practical, we should have revise your some specific anatomy points. That is, we have two lungs in our body, that is the right lung, left lung. Right lung have been divided into superior lobe, inferior lobe and the middle lobe. So this one is the medial lobe, superior lobe, inferior lobe, and the, whereas the left lung has been divided into only superior lobe and the inferior lobe. So here is the cardiac notch. With this basic, we know that these lungs has been connected with the trachea, and which has been divided into the bronchioles, terminal bronchioles and the respiratory bronchioles, which finally connected with your alveoli. So together they form the acini. Here you can see that your trachea can goes directly and come to the alveoli. So for finally there are the respiratory bronchioles, these are the alveoli, and there are the acini duct. So together they form the acini, and this acini is called as the functional unit. So there are the many acini in the lung, and these acini togetherly communicate with each other by the pores of cone. So these are the very important things, because infection from the one acini should go to the other acini, and that's why this communication is there. But it is not for the infection, basically it is for the some other purposes. Infection is the secondary thing which goes from one lung to the one acini to the other acini. So coming to the today's topic, that is the pneumonia, which is usual, the basically it is called as the infection of the lung parenchyma. So there are the acini in your body, and when these acini has been infected by the bacilli, so they fill these alveoli by some liquid or neutrophils instead of the ear. So when this ear replaces this fluid and neutrophils to the fill these acini, then it is called as the consolidation. So in short, the infection of the lung parenchyma, that is the functional unit of acini, and when there is no air, then it is called as the consolidation of the lung. So pneumonia is classified depending on the anatomic location, or by the etiology, or by the your clinical setting. So according to anatomy, it can be divided into the lobar, bronchopneumonia or interstitial pneumonia. So we will see that one by one. So in today's practical, you have the two gross basically. One is for the bronchopneumonia, another one is the lobar pneumonia. So clearly by this picture, you can come to know that this is the bronchopneumonia. In lobar pneumonia, the anatomical difference is there. In case of the lobar pneumonia, one lobe is involved, whereas in case of the bronchopneumonia, it is the patchy involvement of the one lobe or full of the lung can be involved. So coming to the bronchopneumonia gross, here you can see that there is a lung slice measuring around the 10 into 8 into 1.5 centimeter, and the pleural surface shows the fibrinous pleurisy. So here I would like to tell you something, that this is the normal pleurisy of the lung, which is a glistening, which is called as the glistening. Whereas in this case, here you can see that this translucency has been gone. So here it is called as the serofibrinous. And the second thing I would like to mention is, here you see that there are the bronchioles, small bronchiole and bronchioles, and surrounding that there is a consolidation, or surrounding that there are the airless spaces. So this is the bronchopneumonia. Why bronchopneumonia? Because the spaces are in the patchy. Okay, these spaces are in the patchy areas, they present as a patchy. So this is the bronchopneumonia gross specimen. Microscopically, how it looks, it is filled with the neutrophils. These bronchioles are the filled with the neutrophils, and surrounding capillaries are dilated with the alveoli are filled with the exudates. So this is the gross and microscopy of your bronchopneumonia. So this is the gross showing the lung tissue measuring 10 into 8 into 1.5 centimeter, whereas the pleura is showing the fibrinous pleurisy, and cut surface shows the patchy gray brown consolidation areas. Coming to the lobar pneumonia, this lobar pneumonia again is divided into 4 stages, that is the congestion, red hepatization, gray hepatization, resolution. So before going to the gross, I would like to take you from the microscopy views. Why microscopy? Then I will discuss you later on. So first there are the first one is the acute stage, which is called as the congestion. Ok Okay, first one is the congestion. Another one stage is called as the red hepatization. So basically, when there is alveoli, and these alveoli got the bacilli or any bacterial infection, neutrophils come in the first defense mechanism for this. So remember that whenever you have the bacilli or bacteria inside the body, first one is the neutrophil, that is the rule. So these are the bacilli and these are the neutrophils. So due to this, bacilli and neutrophil come with the some amount of RBCs, and these your capillaries in the wall of your alveoli are congested, that is dilated. So this is called as the first stage of your pneumonia or the congestion. Now coming to the red hepatization, as the amount of this neutrophil is increasing and more dilations, more and more RBCs come in the action, and with that there are the cefalofibrin strands also will come there. So accordingly their air has been gone and it is replaced by the exudative fluid. So what will happen due to this? Due to this, your lung will become spongy or hard, and it looks like red. So it is called as the red hepatization, and spongy in hard is to the consistency, so it becomes like a liver. So it is called as the hepatization. So it is called as the red hepatization. So microscopic changes are increase in neutrophil and the fibrin and the RBCs. So next stage, what happen is that neutrophils are now decreasing in the number, macrophages will come in the action, and now these fibrins deposits are getting contracted, so that there will be the gap between the alveoli wall and this process. So there is a clear space between this. This is called as the red hepatization. Again here air is not that much in the volume and hardness is there in the consistency, so it is called as the red hepatization. The next stage is resolution, that is all this mess has been scavenged by your enzymatic digestion or exudation, and the normal capillaries are there, so this granular part only remain there. So this is called as the resolution. These are the normal four stages, but it doesn't mean that there is any thumb rule that pneumonia should follow all these three to four phases sequentially. Sometime with the treatment nowadays, red hepatization is also not there in the patient. So now coming to the gross, as I told you, when there is a red hepatization, more and more RBCs and liver become hard and firm. So this is the lung tissue, most probably of the left side. So it is affected and it is become a consolidated. Here you can see that the red, dry and granular areas are there. Red, dry and granular areas. So this is the airless red and dry granular areas. Again here you can see that pleurisy is glistening. So pleura is glistening over here. From the other side, I have not took the photograph. The serofibrinous pleurisy is there. So this is the gross of the red hepatization. Now coming to the gray hepatization, I told you gray means color has been changed and not red now. So here you can see that lower lobe is been affected, and which is around 10 cm, like 10 into 5 cm and consolidated. So these are the features. Again there is a dry, granular and gray area. Okay, so this is the one lobe has been involved. So this is, that's why it is the lobar pneumonia, and most probably it is type of the your gray hepatization and not the bronchopneumonia. So coming to the photomicrograph, this is the exact photomicrograph of the slide which we have for your practical. Here you can see that again there are the clear spaces. Okay, so there are the clear spaces, and filled with these all small dots are the neutrophils. All small dots are the neutrophils. I took the photograph only from the scanner view. So these are the neutrophils. There are the clear spaces. Okay, so this is the diagram of your pneumonia, and which phase? Most probably it is a gray hepatization. Why gray hepatization? Because when these spaces has been smudged and granular debris are there, neutrophils are very less in number, then only it will become a resolution phase. So as the neutrophils are there in the dot forms, more in number rather than the RBC, so it is a more favors towards the your gray hepatization. Okay, or the phase before resolution. So these are the gross for today's practical. So going into the conclusion, you learn today these four figures or four gross features. One is the for the your pneumonia, it is called as the red hepatization. This one is for the gray hepatization. Here clearly you can see that in red hepatization color is red, dry and granular patches are there, but involving the one lobe. Here gray hepatization, again dry granular consolidation, but again involving the one lobe. In both cases pleura is lost its glistening power and now it looks like a serofibrinus. So here are the another two figures, that is the two photographs. One is from the one specimen, both specimens showing the patchy. This is the lung tissue again, which is showing the patchy consolidation. If you are able to see that, these are the patchy consolidating areas again in the lung. And here also you can see that there is a patchy consolidation which is around the bronchioles. So this is the bronchopneumonia. Thank you.